everybody. Thanks a lot for tuning in for another dupes video. These are some of the most popular videos on my channel, and they are also consequently some of the hardest to turn out. A lot of times I'm working on these on and off for months before they actually become a video, so thank you for your patience and thank you for your requests. I'll definitely link to my most recent dupes videos below, but I've duped some of Charlotte Tilbury's bestsellers, and I've also taken the Bobbi Brown Crushed Liquid Lip line and duped about half of that line. Lip dupes are some of my favorite things to do. But in this video, we're gonna put the focus on Fenty Beauty, which is one of Sephora's most popular brands, and for good reason. They're a great brand, and when I do these videos, I'm not trying to say, like, eh, that brand's not worth it, they're no good, try this stuff instead, just brush them off. Like, no, what I'm saying is you can take inspiration from some of these wildly popular products and get a similar look for a lower price tag if you are more confined budget-wise, or you just prefer to spend less on beauty. Also, I do hear from a lot of people who say, like, I'm just not comfortable with the whole online ordering of beauty products, especially at certain prices. I want to see it in person, but I'm in a rural area and I don't live close to a Sephora or an Ulta, and I understand that completely. So for this video, a couple months back, I purchased some of the best-selling products on Sephora's website where Fenty Beauty is concerned. Focusing in on the color cosmetics, we've got some contour and highlight things, several different lip products here. One thing I will say, I feel like I've experienced some products that are similar to the foundation and the concealer and the powder from this line, but I'm not quite so comfortable talking about certain dupes for face coverage products because I am one skin type. I'm a normal skin type, and I feel like I might have a tendency of getting more consistent results brand to brand than someone with really oily skin or really dry skin who might pick up on different nuances between the two. You know what I'm saying? I think it's harder to know whether my foundation dupe that I might be giving is actually gonna perform like a dupe for everyone. Kind of same with concealers. And then another factor at play is shade range, because then are you gonna go and find exact shade dupes for everything in the high-end foundation or concealer range? You know, what are we talking about here? So I could say that I feel like the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage for me on my normal skin performs a lot like the Fenty Beauty Foundation, and I could say that the e.l.f. 16-Hour Camo Concealer performs a lot like the Fenty Concealer for me, and the Maybelline Fit Me Powder can give me a similar look to the Fenty Setting Powder. But those are my own personal experiences that cater to my specific skin tone and my skin type. And if you're different from me in those two avenues, I can't make any guarantees. That's what I'm saying there. Now, let's move on to the dupes that I have to share with you in this video. First off, we're gonna talk about the matchsticks. Now, I've got a couple of dupes where this is concerned. I've had the trio of matchsticks since this brand was new on Sephora's website, and I have the shade called Amber here, which is a really terrific tone for contouring. However, my big complaint with the matchsticks has been that I feel they drag and kind of pull across the skin and do take a little extra effort to actually blend in. There's just a little too much dryness in this formula for my liking, but I did pop that on the left side of my face. The left side is the Fenty stuff, the right side is the drugstore stuff. So I got that blended in, and then the dupe I feel for this product is this Maybelline Master Contour Stick. Now, this is in the shade Light, and if you get the shade Light, it's gonna be a split stick situation, so you're gonna have half your stick be a light shade that could be used for brightening. It's not shimmery, it's just like almost like a concealer. But the contour side is darn near identical shade-wise to Fenty's Amber, and then it blends in so much more easily. Really creamy, yet very lightweight on the skin, and I feel like I turn out the same effect. So if you wanna get into some cream contouring, like the idea of a stick, but wanna save some money, I say go for this Maybelline Master Contour Stick. Now, when I got these Fenty Match Sticks, they do a really cool thing, by the way. They magnetize together. Like, I can't dupe that. But when I got these, I got three. One was kind of a blushy shade called Yacht Life, which I was not able to find a real dupe for in my collection. But I also have this shimmery highlight shade called Starstruck. Oh, there's also a creamy concealer-esque color as well, which just does not really pair up to the light side of this stick. But anyway, talking about the shimmer here. So Starstruck is a really pretty shimmery tone, but again, with the dryness of texture, it's just not super pleasant to blend in. I feel like I have to do a little extra pressure on the skin, which can interfere with your foundation underneath, you know? But ultimately, once it is blended in, it gives you this light kind of shimmery glaze across the skin. It's very pretty. So I, again, applied that to this side of my face, and then to the other side, I'm using my LA Girl Velvet Highlight Contour Stick, and this is in the shade Luminous. And this actually is a really similar similar texture to the Fenty, but it does have that little bit smoother glide that just makes it a bit more user-friendly in my opinion. So you blend that in and I feel like I have a very similar look, which is just kind of lightly glowy, lightly dewy. I can't really point to a real distinct highlight on either side. They just both give that light glow that's not too frosty, actually. Next up, one of my favorite products from Fenty's line would probably be this Split Pan Kilowatt Highlight, and it's in the shade Lightning Dust and Fire Crystal. So Lightning Dust is a little bit more like the subtle side. I feel like it's ever so slightly warmer in tone and just a little more smooth and pearlescent, whereas the Fire Crystal side is even brighter, just a little bit more pronounced on the skin. And I think it's pretty, and I really do like the effect of both of these highlights on. What we're gonna hone in on here is the Fire Crystal side for this application. And so I did put that on top of my matchstick, which maybe provided just a hint of moisture underneath this highlight, but not a ton. And I got that on there, and as you know, very pretty highlight. Can't take anything away from it. But I do have this sample size. It came like with an Ulta order of this Milani Afterglow in Strobe Light. And it is identical in effect, in texture, really, to the Fenty shade. So I've got that going on my right cheek, and I just feel like the end result is so, so identical. I mean, when you really mimic a texture in a highlight, that's so important because it can show on the skin. You know, textures that are more dry and chunky, like, it'll have this level of visibility on the skin, right? But I feel like both of these just kind of mesh in with the look, and you could go even further with either of these. They both have an even bigger range, but this is just kind of like the level I like to play in. But I do want to talk about that other side for a second, because I found another product that I think kind of caters to both, and it's this Physicians Formula Warm Nude little highlighter palette. And as you can see, it's kind of got a mix there. And I do feel like when I blend across certain colors, I can get the same look as either side of this. For example, kind of blending downward in this first row, I feel like I get the effect of the more subtle side of this, the Lightning Dust side. But then if I really focus in just on these top two, I get that really brightened intensity, and it looks a little bit more like the Fire Crystal side. So just something to think about. If you own this and you're interested in getting the same effect, think about using it in those ways. I know that's very pinpointed, and you do need to operate with kind of a smaller highlight brush to make that happen. But if you sort of stay out of this bronzy zone right down in here, I think you're gonna find some very similar looks to this. Now we're gonna talk about a lip gloss. This is the Fenty Gloss Balm. These are super duper popular. This is just the shade Fenty Glow. I also have the more pinky one called Fussy, but I swear I've got countless shades that look similar to that, but nothing feels like a real dupe. But I did find a dupe for this. And actually, you guys pointed out that something might be similar in that Milani lip color try-on when I was using those Keep It Full lip plumpers, and some of them have that shimmery finish that really mimics this. So as I was trying on a few and comparing them, I'm like, oh my gosh, it really is a similar like thickness and texture and comfort level really on the lips. And I found one that's the exact tone of Fenty Glow, and it's the shade called Rosy Bronze from Milani. So watch these going on. This is really cool. We're gonna put the Fenty on the left side of the lips, top and bottom, and it's sheer, you know? It's a light gloss in terms of color intensity, but yet it does have a lot of thickness and I think a lot of moisturization in it. And then I put the Milani on the other side, and I felt like it really nicely mimicked just the bit of depth that Fenty Glow does have. All that shine is so there, and just the thickness of the product really has a similar look on the lips, like not going into lines, really just giving this glass-like look on top of the lips. So if you're looking for an alternative to Fenty Glow, check out Milani's Rosy Bronze. It's one of the new shades. Next up, we're gonna talk about my three shades of the Stunna lip paints. These I know are a super popular Fenty product, and I tried to go for three colors that, number one, appealed to me. Number two, I did feel like I was hearing a lot about just across the board. And this shade called Uncuffed, it's so pretty. And this is a great formula, by the way. It's very liquidy. I actually feel like I want to shake these up before I use them. They go on the lips feeling pretty thin, but 100% opaque and pigmented. And while they do have that matte dry down, I don't feel like they're overly uncomfortable on the lips. And the wear is pretty good, and the applicator is pretty good. It's kind of unique. It's got this little kind of hourglass shape, but then look how it kind of angles off there right at the top. And it makes it so, so easy to follow that lip line. And then just the overall package packaging. This is a glass bottle here. It feels very deluxe. So there's a lot going right with this Fenty line, but if you want to dupe the color, if you want to get that same effect on your lips, finding something that does have that matte dry down is not really all that hard. The hard part was mimicking the exact shade. So I finally did it, and this shade called Uncuffed, you're going to see that going on the left side of my lips. Again, deep, neutral, little bit of rosiness, but I do think I found the exact shade dupe in one from NYX called the Liquid Suede Cream Lipstick, and this feels a little more mousse-like going on, but this shade Soft Spoken is on point for the color, and by the time the dry down happens, it all looks the same. You know, it's that matte, even look on the lips. I tried literally dozens of drugstore neutral liquid lipsticks to try to dupe this, and this had like fallen out of my basket in my drawer and was like off in the side. I was like, oh, let's try that one. That was the dupe. It was hiding from me. So that was really satisfying to finally hit on that. Here is a really gorgeous shade from the Fenty line, and this is the shade Unlocked. This is a beautiful hot pink kind of fuchsia color. Again, all the same things apply. They're very consistent across the board. These Fenty lip paints, with being so thin yet so pigmented, I haven't tried one yet that seems to have gone on unevenly or something, but I've got that on the left side of my lips, and then I feel like I really matched that level of brightness and intensity with the Revlon Ultra HD Matte Lip Color in HD Obsession. One thing to know about this is that this will not dry down as fully as the Fenty. Therefore, it will feel a little more comfortable on the lips, but it just won't have maybe quite the staying power, so just be aware of that. But if you're trying to mimic that really bright pink color, this is a great one to test out. And lastly, we've got the color called Uncensored. So a really classic red here, but I would say a little bit deeper. I have so many red liquid lipsticks in my collection, and the thing I was noticing over and over again was so many were too bright. They stayed like on this level of like Besame Red Hot Red, you know, being a really pure red, but not having that hint of dry down that takes it more to like a blood red. You know what I mean? That's really what this is. Sorry to be gory. But I think the shade that totally mimics that, especially after the dust settles, everything dries down, these two just look so similar. And it's the Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink, and this is in the shade called Pioneer. Formula-wise, I would say this is the most similar formula to the Fenty of any dupe I've mentioned. It's pretty liquidy, maybe not quite as liquidy as the Fenty, but close. But it has a similar thinness of feel going on. There's a nice applicator here. While it's different from Fenty, it still allows you to be very precise. And the staying power is super, super hardcore, maybe even a little bit stronger than the staying power of the Fenty. So again, what's important to do if you're ever trying to find like matte liquid lipstick dupes in your collection, make sure as you're swatching them out, like you're not just looking at the way things look initially or on your lips initially. You kind of need to wait for the whole dry down to happen to see just how similar everything ends up looking, because the Fenty shades are pretty good about not changing too much, but they do have just a subtle dry down, and many other liquid lipsticks do as well. So I was really satisfied about how everything comes together here with these two shades. So guys, that's all that I have right now for Fenty dupes. And when I was looking up bestsellers, this was one of them, and I swear I just don't have anything currently that dupes this. It's the How Many Carats All Over Diamond Veil. It's like a pure glitter veil, you know, and I don't have anything that's really exactly like that. So that might be a product when you're thinking, bestsellers, that does show up as a bestseller, but I couldn't find the dupe. But here's what I want to know from you guys. Is there anything else from this brand or anything from other brands, any just brands in general that you would like to know about dupes from? Please let me know in the comments section. Tell me now, because I need to start working on them, because it takes me a while to get satisfied. I'm very picky about dupes and I want them to be exact, and it takes me quite a while to work on these videos. But thank you so much for taking time to watch, and I will see you again very soon. Bye.